Hi everyone, welcome to Lei's Real Talk. I'm Lei. In addition to 5G, semiconductors, and vaccines, there are three new frontiers where China is fiercely competing with the United States in science and technology. These tech wars will shape Sino-US relations for the next 5 years. Blockchain, the technology behind cryptocurrency, is considered the future of everything that can bring the next generation of the internet. As early as 2016, Beijing included blockchain in the 13th five-year national plan. In October 2019, Xi Jinping led the Politburo of the CCP's Central Committee to learn about blockchain. In March of this year, the 14th five-year plan marked the regime's biggest push for the technology in recent years. But contrary to the technology's core concept of decentralization, the CCP wants to have a centralized version. While Beijing continues to crack down on cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin mining, which it perceives as destabilizing, it wants to take a central role by creating an advanced blockchain industrial system. The Blockchain Service Network, or BSN, was kicked off 2 years ago with the help of state-owned China Mobile and China Union Pay, and a state policy think tank called the State Information Center. BSN is a project aimed at propelling China into a leadership position by helping companies, government agencies, and financial institutions around the world to create blockchain applications at a low cost. The platform's goal is to provide the infrastructure and to enable interoperability between different blockchains and protocols, helping the technology become mainstream. The CCP ambitiously launched the BSN's global platform on April 25, 2020. By comparison, Western governments have not paid enough attention to blockchain, according to Voice of America. While responding to China's challenges in industries such as 5G, they have done little to address the regime's expansion into blockchain. So far, the White House Office of Science and Technology Policy has not listed blockchain as a priority. Current U.S. policies focus only on protecting investor rights, preventing illegal securities, money laundering, and tax evasion. In July, the CCP hosted the 4th annual World Artificial Intelligence Conference, and Xiao Yaqing, the Minister of Industry and Information Technology, announced that China ranks first in the world for total number of AI patents. The CCP has long planned strategically for AI. From the Made in China 2025 campaign in 2015, the 13th five-year plan, and the report of the 19th National Congress in 2017, to the 14th five-year plan this year, AI has been elevated as a national strategy. The State Council specially launched the New Generation AI Development Plan in 2017, which spelled out three phases for reaching its goals. First, achieve top-level world ranking in AI technology and application by 2020. Then, by 2025, achieve major breakthroughs in AI theory and use AI as the main driver for industrial and economic transformation in building a smart society. And finally, by 2030, become the world's leading AI innovation center. According to the China Internet Development Report released this year, the Chinese AI industry was a 303 billion yuan or $47 billion business in 2020. By comparison, the AI market in the US will be $22 billion in 2021, less than half of that of China from a year ago, based on estimates by Global Industry Analysts, Inc. On March 19th, the National Security Council for Artificial Intelligence, chaired by former Google CEO Eric Schmidt, issued a report. It pointed out that AI is expanding the window of vulnerability the United States has already entered. China possesses the might, talent, and ambition to surpass the United States as the world leader in AI. The Sino-US AI rivalry has far surpassed mere technical competition. It is a war between two ideologies and value systems. In the West, surveillance and privacy concerns in AI applications are debated extensively. But in China, AI provides the CCP with the surveillance that it cannot achieve through human intelligence. 6 years ago, an open letter endorsed by theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking and Tesla founder Elon Musk warned that AI technology might be more dangerous than nuclear weapons. Due to the rapid development of AI in military technology, unmanned warfare has gradually come into reality. Through powerful artificial intelligence and information transmission, military operations can be carried out more lethally and quickly without human involvement. It reveals an ethical problem. Is it moral to exclude human beings in combat and to surrender the power of life and death to an autonomous weapon system? The CCP knows that it cannot command loyalty from the Chinese people, but a computer system is more reliable because it will not subvert the CCP's orders. Having no moral boundaries, the CCP views unmanned war only as a matter of capability and never as an issue of moral responsibility. The U.S.-China AI competition is essentially a war between totalitarianism and democracy. And one key factor to the success of AI applications is computing power. This leads to the next area of competition. In August 2016, China launched the world's first quantum science experimental satellite, Mozi. In 2017, the world's first quantum secure communications network, called the Beijing-Shanghai Mainline Project, passed technical review. This January, China announced that it has established the world's first integrated quantum communication network, combining optical fibers on the ground with satellite links to achieve quantum key distribution over a distance of 4,600 kilometers across China. China's Xinhua News Agency called this the beginning of a heaven-earth wide-area quantum communication network. And China has invested tremendous amount of money on these projects. According to American Enterprise Institute, or AEI, countries that have pledged to invest more than $1 billion in quantum technology research and development are India, the United Kingdom, the United States, France, Germany, and China. But China leads the world with $10 billion invested. That's nearly half of the world's total spending of $22 billion for R&D. The number of patents for quantum research in China is more than twice that of the US. In the field of quantum communication and cryptography, the total number of patents in China in 2018 exceeded that of the United States, the European Union, Japan, and South Korea combined. Pan Jianwei, the leader of quantum science research in China, said in a 2018 interview, "In the early days of the development of modern information science, we were just followers and learners. Now we have the chance to become leaders." In October 2019, Google announced that it had successfully developed a quantum processor called Sycamore, with a processing speed that's 1.57 billion times faster than the fastest supercomputer. A year later, Pan's team announced that it had built a quantum computer prototype called Nine Chapters, which was 10 billion times faster than Google's Sycamore. This poses a threat to the United States. The AEI report stated that if China gains an advantage in quantum computing, before the U.S. cyber defense capability is upgraded, U.S. national security becomes vulnerable. Tom Stefanik, a military and intelligence technology expert at the Brookings Institute, said that the use of quantum algorithms in mature and powerful quantum computers will make the information encrypted with traditional mathematical modes invisible. This means that if the Chinese regime masters the supercomputing power of quantum machines, it can crack and decode information in its components' networks. In 2018, the US government deemed quantum computing a strategic imperative. And that same year, the Trump administration released the National Strategic Overview for Quantum Information Science. Subsequently, the National Quantum Initiative Act, which was aimed at accelerating the R&D of quantum computing, was passed by Congress. Unlike China's government-controlled approach, the United States has developed quantum technology in cooperation with the private sectors. In June, IBM unveiled the world's first commercial quantum computer in Germany. In July, it launched Japan's first quantum computer for commercial applications. At the U.S.-Japan summit in April, quantum computing was one of the areas of cooperation discussed by President Biden and Japan's Prime Minister Suga. The Biden administration has implemented a strategy of selective decoupling from the CCP. At the same time, it's also forming strategic alliances with allies to jointly respond to technological competition from the Chinese Communist Party. We have yet to see how the tech wars between US and China unfold, so stay tuned and I'll keep you informed of any developments.